Have you ever misplaced your wallet and couldn't remember where you left it? Or have you ever checked your phone, secured your front door, or entered a room only to forget the reason for being there? If you're awake for 16 hours today, that means your senses are operational for 57,600 seconds. That's a massive amount of information, so naturally, you won't retain most of it. Forgetfulness is the occasional inability to recall things due to changes in the brain. Many people harbor misconceptions about forgetfulness, often linking it directly to serious memory issues. Here are several lesser-known reasons why we forget things from time to time. Flawed memory. It's a common misconception that human memory is flawless. In reality, our memory system is far from perfect, which leads to errors like missing details, forgetting specific facts, or even mixing up or distorting memories. In the renowned gorilla experiment by Harvard researchers, participants watched a video of two teams passing basketballs, one team wearing white shirts and the other in black. Viewers were instructed to count the passes made by the team in white shirts, focusing solely on this task. Unbeknownst to them, as they concentrated on the count, a person in a gorilla suit walked through the scene. Half of the viewers didn't notice the gorilla, effectively making it invisible. This experiment underscores two points. We often miss much of what occurs around us, and we're unaware of how much we miss. Your memory and attention are limited, meaning you're bound to forget things occasionally. Intelligence isn't the issue. Many are reluctant to acknowledge their forgetfulness due to the fear of social judgment. Consider when you know a fact but can't seem to recall it, like having something on the tip of your tongue but being unable to articulate it. This can lead to feelings of embarrassment and perceived stupidity as if it reflects poorly on our intelligence. However, research indicates that forgetting is an integral part of learning, not a sign of low intelligence. The brain isn't malfunctioning when it forgets. Rather, it might be intentionally discarding trivial details to focus on what's more crucial for making real-world decisions, according to Professor Blake Richards from the University of Toronto. When your brain is bombarded with conflicting memories, it complicates your ability to make informed decisions. The type of information the brain opts to forget can depend on how relevant it is to future interactions. For instance, a supermarket cashier interacts with countless customers and is likely to forget most of them quickly, while a barista at their coffee van might remember their regular customers more distinctly. Age is just one factor. Forgetfulness is not solely a problem for the elderly. It can occur at any age. You may have forgotten where you placed your keys, missed an appointment, or couldn't recall a colleague's name at some point. Forgetfulness isn't exclusively related to aging. Factors such as stress, sleep deprivation, certain medications, mental health conditions, and lifestyle choices also play significant roles. You'll tend to forget things more easily. For instance, stress can greatly influence forgetfulness. Studies have shown that stressful situations can activate a brain enzyme called protein kinase C, which impairs short-term memory and affects the brain's decision-making and focus capabilities. The activation of PKC due to stress makes you more susceptible to forgetfulness regardless of age. Unless forgetfulness is severe, persistent, and impacts your daily life significantly, it's not indicative of Alzheimer's or other types of dementia. Misconceptions about attention and interest. Sometimes forgetfulness is mistakenly attributed to a lack of care or attention. You can forget a piece of information just seconds after using it, especially if you don't expect to use it again soon. According to a professor of psychology at Penn State, Brad Weibel, it is commonly believed that you will remember specific details about the things you're attending to, but our experiments show that this is not necessarily true. In an experiment, Weibel and his colleague Hui Chen tested the memories of undergraduate students, divided into several groups. Each group performed a version of the experiment to replicate the outcomes using various types of information, like numbers, letters, or colors. In each trial, participants were shown four characters on a screen displayed in a square formation. For example, this could be three numbers and one letter. They were asked to identify which corner of the square the letter was located. After a set amount of time, the letters vanished from the screen and participants were asked to remember where the letter had been. This part of the task was supposed to be simple because participants hardly ever made a mistake. After repeating the same easy task, participants were asked an unexpected question to test if they could remember the information they used to locate the letter. Four letters appeared on the screen and the participant was asked to identify which one had appeared on the previous screen. Only 25% of the participants identified the correct letter, the same percentage as would be expected to randomly guess the correct letter. The same results were obtained when participants were asked to locate colors, odd numbers, and even numbers. The researchers called it attribute amnesia. It's a phenomenon in which a person uses a piece of information to perform a task, but is then unable to report specifically what that information was as little as 1 second later. After the surprise trial, the same question was repeated on the next trial. However, it was no longer a surprise. Participants did dramatically better, with an average of correct answers between 65% and 95% across the different experiments. The researchers point out that the result shows people's expectations play a key role in determining what they remember, even for information they are specifically using. "It seems like memory is sort of like a camcorder," said Weibel. "If you don't hit the record button on the camcorder, it's not going to remember what the lens is pointed at. But if you do hit the record button, in this case, you know what you're going to be asked to remember. Then the information is stored." The takeaway is that even when you're paying full attention and deeply interested in something, it's possible to forget it. Strategies to combat forgetfulness. 1. Jot things down. To avoid forgetting, write down your thoughts and tasks as soon as they come to mind. Whether you prefer digital notes or classic pen and paper, keeping a record helps retain important information. In some cases, you can even hire a VA to manage your to-do list, such as reminding you about an appointment and telling you where you left your glasses. Regardless of the method you set up, what matters is that it works for you and helps you remember things. 2. Create a specific spot for items. If you frequently misplace everyday items like keys or wallets, assign a specific place for them. This practice can save time and reduce stress caused by searching for lost items. These items are usually part of our daily routines. It's normal to forget where we keep them from time to time. It's a memory slip that can happen to anyone. Sometimes these items are on your desk, but they're hidden under a stack of papers, leaving you to scratch your head where you put them. "I hate looking for things. It wastes my time and stresses me out." So, I try to find a unique spot for any of the items I use often. For example, I keep my keys and wallet in the inner zippered section of my laptop bag when I'm at work. There's no rule. The idea is to find where you keep things that matter to you so you can reach them quickly and without stress. 3. Modify your lifestyle. Enhancing your lifestyle can bolster your memory. Adequate sleep, a balanced diet, regular physical activity, and social interaction are crucial for maintaining a sharp memory. If you're always forgetting things, it could be that you're not getting enough sleep, your eating habit is broken, or you're overworking yourself. Studies have identified 6 lifestyle choices that can improve memory and minimize forgetfulness. In one experiment involving over 29,000 people that lasted for 10 years, researchers found that diet was found to be the most controllable factor of the 6. Those who ate 7 of 12 healthy food items daily experienced less forgetfulness than those who didn't. They found that weekly exercise of at least 150 minutes of moderate intensity or 75 minutes of vigorous intensity fixes forgetfulness. Talking to people and being social, like going to events, visiting friends, or chatting online at least 2 times a week can improve memory. Forgetfulness is a natural part of life. It's not a brain problem. If you're forgetful, don't feel bad about yourself. First, check to see if it's a result of lifestyle habits like stress or other factors. Making the right changes in lifestyle, like managing stress, getting enough sleep, and staying organized, can go a long way in reducing forgetfulness. But if you're experiencing more persistent memory lapses that are interfering with your daily life, the best thing to do is seek medical attention. Memory problems can sometimes be an early sign of underlying medical conditions, and a healthcare professional can help diagnose and address any potential issues. In the end, recognizing these common misconceptions about forgetfulness is critical to better navigating the problem.